Hey there, friends. Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to another music video reaction continuing the series of the greatest pop songs of all time. The contender for this reaction is Lifehouse, Whatever It Takes, released in 2007 as the second single to their fourth studio album, Who We Are. So just to glean over the chart performance, in 2008, this song peaked at number 33 on the Billboard Hot 100, number 10 on Adult Contemporary, 3 on Adult Top 40, 28 on Christian Songs, and 17 on the Mainstream Top 40. Year-end, number 23 on Adult Contemporary, and number 2 on Adult Top 40 for the year-end chart. Alright, so Lifehouse, Whatever It Takes, and I remember this playing a lot on VH1's Top 20 Music Video Countdown back in the day. It comes on at the grocery store where I work all the time, just came on today, actually. So without further ado, let's dive in. Jason Wade, the lead singer. This video was so 2007. So, I do like Jason Wade's voice. Of course, Lifehouse has other hits like You and Me, First Time Hanging by a Moment. They have some other hits, not just this one. I like his voice. I think it's not glossy. That's not the right word. I think it is just accessible enough for an adult contemporary audience, hence why they were so successful in that adult contemporary, adult alternative neat niche. But just gritty enough to give it sort of like a typical radio rock post-grunge bent to it. I do like the sort of subtle shimmer on the guitars. The drums are fairly poignant. Of course, you know, there's like some kind of subtle orchestral arrangements. And obviously some chanted choir vocals filling in those post-chorus fills before we get into the verses. Or the second verse, rather. It's interesting. Again, it's 2007 as fuck. I feel like with the exodus of rock music from the top 40 in the last 15 years, if this were to be a big hit today, it would be far and away the heaviest thing on the top 40. And I think that there are enough rock and radio rock signifiers to designate it as such. But it's also like I could see this being compared to like Daughtry, early Daughtry at least, because if you've heard new Daughtry, Jesus Christ, that shit is heavy. But like early Daughtry, Maroon 5, One Republic, especially like that Soccer Mom, Adult Contemporary, Adult Top 40 sort of drivel, and some of it's a lot better than others. And this is a lot more innocuous and a lot more enjoyable and pleasant than some of the worst offenders in that regard. Like The Fray, How to Save a Life. I could do without that song real fucking quick. No offense to anyone who likes that song. But let's continue. The guitars ramp up a little bit there. There goes the milk and cereal.
Let you down. If you give me a chance,
Hey, the milk and cereal is back to normal. Yeah, it's a pretty good song. I'd say about as good. Again, there's some suggestions. Daughtry, Gavin DeGraw, Leon Rimes, who we just already reacted to. Most recent video. And Switchfoot. Pretty pleasant, well-performed, well-produced pop rock power ballad. I guess you could say it suffers from somewhat hackneyed songwriting, but it, you know, has a lot more emotional intelligence in the songwriting than a lot of pop music today. And again, if something like this were to be a major force on pop radio on the top 40 today, it would be far and away the heaviest thing, but far and away probably the smartest thing there. Yeah, it definitely filled the niche in the mid to late 2000s, and a lot of those acts didn't have quite the staying power. Some of them did, like Maroon 5, obviously, but that's because they sold the fuck out. It's an interesting composition, interesting arrangement, I should say. I say that a lot, but I guess that's because I keep singling out songs I think are good enough to talk about. Because, like, again, this series is about finding the greatest pop songs of all time, and I know that's going to eventually include songs I don't like, but their chart success was just such that I cannot argue against it. So I know that, like, I want to prolong that as much as I can. I don't want to just talk about, like, I don't want to force myself to listen to songs I don't enjoy. I don't think I would have chosen the song if I didn't like it enough to, you know, give it props and talk about the elements that, the strengths, like the vocals, the guitars. Again, in that second verse, those guitars are, picking up a little bit with the, a little more depth, a little bit more, oomph. Like, I'm trying to find the right word. But yeah, like the guitars carry the composition, but as it goes on, it gets, they picked up the, not the intensity, because it's not an intense song, right, per se. They picked up the zeal, I guess. I don't know. But it's a pretty decent song. Let me know what you think about Lifehouse, Whatever It Takes, in the comments below. If you enjoyed this reaction, please like, subscribe, hit the bell to get notified when another video drops. See you on the next one. Take care.